Global markets were much calmer on Thursday after China's central bank said it supports a stable, strong currency for the long term. That eased concerns that the yuan was on track for a disorderly devaluation. Emerging market stocks rebounded from their lowest level since 2011. European stocks halted their biggest two-day slide this year, and commodities rose for the first time in 3 days. And it might come as a little surprise, but McDonald's has one of the highest ratios of CEO pay to that of an average worker, coming in at a whopping 644-1. The fast food chain's pay scale is in focus after the SEC last week approved a requirement for public companies to disclose a similar metric each year. Corporations probably won't like the new requirement, as it is expected to be used by unions and activists to shame CEOs over their pay. And a barrel of oil in Alberta now costs about the same as a case of beer or a bottle of premium whiskey. Western Canadian Select, the benchmark for the country's heavy crude, fell below $30 a barrel on Wednesday for the first time since 2008. Prices have been hit by the global oil rout, a recovery in production, and shutdowns of key refineries and pipelines in the U.S. Midwest. This has driven Canadian crude to a $20 discount versus the U.S. benchmark WTI, the largest gap in a year. For the Financial Post, I'm Jonathan Ratner.